Hello, 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 everybody. Thanks for watching. Basically, a lot of you that are going to be watching today know me from streaming. I was on Twitch for quite a few months. I got kind of burned out. I did it for so many months straight, non-stop, every day, so many hours, and I don't know, it's like, I'm burned out. It's been a couple of months since I've done that non-stop, but, you know, it's not fun anymore. I tried it for a little while, and it's not me, you know? This is something new for me. YouTube, obviously, but we're gonna try this. We're gonna do Fallout 3. It's gonna be a series. I will almost positively do this from start to end, but it'll at least give me a little bit more time to manage my own time. I'll be able to do stuff for myself, and I won't have to work around a schedule and all that kind of stuff. So we're gonna do this because I like to entertain you guys. I like to give you guys something to watch when there's nothing on TV like every other day. Speaking of TV, every series is ending. We'll talk about that in a minute. Anyway, Fallout 3, 2008 classic. I love this game. I played it a couple times, beat it. Never played the DLC, but I do have the DLC now, so let's get it started.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I'm gonna try to keep my mouth shut during the cutscenes and stuff like that, because for people who haven't played Fallout 3, it's a fantastic game. And I really recommend you get it. It's $20 right now for the game and all the DLC on Steam. Or, well, I don't know how much it is on Xbox Live or anything like that, but we're playing on PC, so. Excuse the hell out of me.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't set the world on fire.
Go, guys, here we go. Start Fallout 3, man. It's been a couple of years, 2-3 years since I played this.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God, to justice, to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters. And no one ever leaves.
So as I was saying, TV shows are ending. It's so surreal. Breaking Bad just had its finish, series finale, and so did Dexter. Man, I don't know what I'm going to watch next year. No clue.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl?
You can't tell?
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy,
damn right you do,
baby boy.
Not beautiful. I'm sexy. Sexy, biatch. Oh, sexy as hell.
A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
I think Slip's a good name. How about that? Slip? Anybody? Yeah, I think that works. Slip's a great name for a baby.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Alright. Here we go. We'll go with Caucasian, because I am Caucasian. We'll go with preset number 6. That's the one I liked. Customize? No, I'm good. Oh, wait. Wait. I could change the eye color. I didn't know that. Oh yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome, guy. Alright, here we go. Moment of truth. Hairstyle. We're gonna leave it at buzzsaw. Hair color. Nah, let's go red. We're gonna go red. All the way red. I was gonna do blue or green, but I like red. We'll do red. Alright. Facial hair. We'll do... Nah. Let's go with backwater. There we go. That's what I like. Yes, I want this to be my character.
You look a lot like your dad.
You look nothing like me.
Oh. Oh. Very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son. Full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're just James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compression. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000.
Cardiac arrest.
Come on.
God damn it.
Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
Sorry if you hear me clear my throat or cough every once in a while. I'm not feeling very well.
Come on over here, son. Come on.
But anyways, again, thanks for watching. I really do appreciate it. We're gonna try this, and hopefully it works out. Everything works out.
Just a year old and
try this series
walking like a pro.
See how it goes.
Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
All right. Let's be a big boy and open the gate. Woohoo! Exit the playpen. Did it. I did it already. I'm way ahead of you. Oh, look at the Your Special book. Okay. Alright, we're gonna go one towards strength. One towards perception. One towards endurance. Nope, I'm good. And two towards intelligence. And everything else, we'll just get it as we level up. Alright. Lock pick skill of 100. Wow.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that?
All right.
Your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Amada. Let's go see Amada. Follow Dad to Amada. Oh no! Bright white screen! 9 years later, so we're 10 now. Oh look, it's my birthday.
You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother.
Young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are.
Oh, did I just hit the mic? I'm sorry about that.
I present to you
that.
Your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once. So have fun.
Oh, you think so, eh? I'm only 10 once. We'll see about that.
Oh, man, you got...
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
You didn't fool me. Just pretended to lie, not to know. Just pretending not to know. How can I pretend to lie? How can somebody pretend to lie? God, I'm such an idiot.
You're such a liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for?
A day with Christine Kendall? Sounds about right.
Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than me and Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
A Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
Well, you should grow up, Paul Hannon.
Nice part.
Grow up.
It's time to cut the cake.
Oh yeah, I get to watch you screw up my cake, you stupid ass. Good job.
How do you like that, Pip-Boy? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Here I am going on about your Pip-Boy, and I clean forgot about your present.
God damn you!
Here you go. Happy birthday. It's not much, but I hope you like it.
Give me a goddamn baseball cap.
Going,
what the hell? Baseball cap. What kind of kid wants a baseball cap for their 10th birthday?
I know you said good ideas. I'm not sure anyone.
All right, let's talk to this old lady. Oh no, I don't want to pickpocket her.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning.
Oh, sweet roll. Oh, thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Besides, that friend of yours.
Now, this asshole's gonna steal my sweet roll.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Oh, yeah? We'll see about
Engage.
You're gonna be sorry, you little...
Ugh, this is supposed to be a...
How do I punch this dude?
Butch, what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone.
Enjoying yourself?
There we right, go. Son.
Thanks for coming,
he didn't
Stanley.
Hurt you, did he?
I know you were busy.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
With the water purifier...
Jonas?
Everything's fine.
All right, Butch. Oh, sure, nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got it all.
Send him right down.
Party, huh? I wasn't...
Can it? I've had it with you, Butch.
Yeah, all right, let's talk to Daddy.
That was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise
present. Oh, a surprise present.
Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Oh, for a few minutes, you say, huh, Dad? A few minutes? All right, let's go talk to Jonas on the reactor level. I think it's this way. Oh, look,
Happy
who's this?
Happy birthday, dearie.
Beatrice.
My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
I'm not a girl and I'm not five, so stop calling me dearie.
Of course you're not five. You're a big 10-year-old man now, aren't you? With your very own Pip-Boy.
Yeah, I got my Pip-Boy, bitch.
You know what I did? Just for the occasion.
Now roll over.
I wrote you a poem. I hope you like it.
A poem? You gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me.
I'd never just copy one of my old poems. Well... There was that one Founder's Day where I couldn't rhyme anything with overseer. But you deserve nothing less than a brand new poem. You can keep it in your Pip-Boy and read it whenever you want.
Nope, I'm good. I'll throw it away on the ground. I'll throw it on the ground. All right, where are we going? Clinic? Reactor level, this way. Reactor level, this way. All right, here we go. Reactor level. We're on the reactor level. Oh, no, we're not. Now we're on the reactor level. And there's that guy. I'm running from him. You can't find me. You can't find me. You can't see me. You can't see me. No, you can't see me. Okay, enough of this bullshit. Come on.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Oh, where is he? Tell him to get his ass down here. Get your ass down here, damn it.
Are you ready for your surprise?
I don't like surprises.
Regardless, I think you'll like this one. You're getting older, and you've got your Pip-Boy. I figure you're old enough for this, too. Your own BB gun.
It's oh, great, a BB gun.
But it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Yep, damn right.
Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me.
All right, let's go. Come on. Through here. Through here. I'll open the door for you. Hurry up. Come on. Move it. Right up in here, huh? You get to kill roaches. Roach-looking things.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
There we go.
I'm sorry you feel that way. Maybe you haven't grown up as much as I thought. If you don't want it, I'm sure I can find someone who does.
Oh, shut up. Damn it. Alright, guys, it's been almost 20 minutes now, so we're going to wrap it up here, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoy this series. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see you in the next episode. See ya.